Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms: Instagram, Prince Miller Entertainment; Facebook, Prince Miller Entertainment; Facebook group, Prince Miller Entertainment TV; and also on our Twitter handle @PMillerENT. Welcome to another edition of our daily news on breaking news. Today is the 17th of May, 2021. So the appeal to the Supreme Court against a High Court decision blocking sitting judges from holding office after attaining 70 is to be lodged today. The government is moving fast as the decision directly affects Chief Justice Luke Malabas as the first judge to reach 70 since the recent constitutional amendment was passed by Parliament and gazetted as law. Chief Justice Malaba attained the age of 70 on Saturday, but as the now amendment section of the Constitution allows, he exercised his option before his birthday to continue until 75 and submitted the required medical certificate that he was in good mental and physical health. However, this was challenged as a matter of urgency in the High Court, where a three-judge panel comprising a lead judge, Justice Appiah Joe and Justice Edith Mushore and Helen Jester Charewa on Saturday, ruled that the particular clause changing the retirement ages of sitting judges required a referendum after passing through Parliament. The Judicial Service Commission has since announced that the Deputy Chief Justice Elizabeth Gwaunza is now the acting Chief Judge in the outcome of the appeal. Justice Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Minister Ziyambi Ziyambi yesterday confirmed the government decision to file the appeal today. "We want to file the appeal against the judgment," he said in response to a question. Under the Constitution, most amendments can become part of the Constitution once they have received the approval of two-thirds of the membership of the National Assembly and of the Senate sitting separately. But amendments to the Declaration of the Rights and to the Chapter on Agricultural Land to require approval in a referendum within 3 months of passing the parliamentary votes, along with the section that details how the Constitution can be amended. High Court judges said the amendment relating to the retirement age of judges also required a referendum, although the full reasons of their judgment are yet to be given. They ruled the amendment could not apply to sitting judges until a referendum is held. It is understood that three judges who heard the urgent application brought by prominent businessman Mr. Frederick Mutanda, Young Lawyers Association of Zimbabwe, and human rights lawyers Mr. Musa Kika need to give their reasons promptly to allow government lawyers to analyze this and to avoid any delay in the hearing of the appeal and the final judicial decision. While the three judges ruled against the retirement ages and so against Chief Justice Malaba's tenure of office, some legal experts have expressed their views in support of the constitutionality of the recent constitutional amendment that got the signature of the President Mnangagwa, since retirement ages are not in the two chapters where amendments require a referendum to the supermajority in Parliament. Commenting on the High Court ruling yesterday, legal expert Mr. Obed Kutu criticized Justice Joe Mushore and Charewa for allegedly failing to make a distinct between a term limit and an age limit. He said the Constitutional Amendment No. 2 Act did not extend the term limit of judges of the Superior Courts, but merely extended the age limit by allowing them to continue occupying judicial office for another 5 years after attaining the age of 70, subject to them providing medical proof that they are still in sound physically and mentally. "This to me is the major weakness of the High Court judgment that was handed down on Saturday, 15 May 2021, said Kutu. "Because Constitutional Amendment No. 2 Act does not extend the term limit of judges of the Superior Courts, there is therefore no need to go to a referendum. Judges of the Constitutional Court have a term limit and cannot be reappointed, and even then would have to retire at 70, or if they exercise their option to continue at 75. Chief Justice Malaba had not yet served 15 years as a Constitutional Court judge, and thus his age limit could lawfully be extended to enable him to serve for another 5 period, subject of course to the requirements of providing a medical certificate. I'm absolutely convinced that the High Court judgment is challengeable in the Supreme Court with a significant degree of prospects of success of the appeal," he said. "Clearly the High Court totally misdirected itself by failing to distinguish between a term limit and an age limit. Prominent lawyer advocate Louis Uriri said by accepting the extension of his term of office, Chief Justice Malaba had further demonstrated his commitment to serving the nation and the justice system. A law is a law because of the validity of its source from within the legal system. The Chief Justice has been appointed in terms of the law deriving from a valid source within the legal system, he said. Advocate Uriri was convinced that all Zimbabweans would benefit from Chief Justice Malaba's continued service in his post. The legal profession in particular will no doubt be equipped to better serve the nation from his commitment to the teaching of superior court tactics and his immense passion for the study and logical application of legal principles. I believe that under his leadership, study and diligence will become the duty of all legal practitioners. This so far has been part of his legacy as Chief Justice, said Uriri. So guys, this article is in the Herald. Of course, Mangonzwana was interview in this one, Obed Kutu. And as you know, the man was MDCT and ZANU-PF. And again, Advocate Uriri, who was representing Emmerson Mnangagwa, the president, during the 2018 election, and it Papa Pagatwa appeal to Supreme Court, and it ED Achita win and my votes are got. So Advocate Uriri was representing ED, and yeah, so of course, one to other, but anyway, guys, I'll come back here later on. I'll give you more details regarding to Nasi Kutini appear to each of Vuma Erika Chaitika regarding to this whole story, which is making headlines on social media. About Chief Justice Luke Malaba, the government is saying the man is too physical fit and strong to continue for another 5 years. That means until he is 75, but at the same time, that decision has been challenged by lawyers, by human rights lawyers, and Young Lawyers Association of Zimbabwe, and again a businessman, Mr. Frederick Mutanda. He's one of those guys. We want this man to retire. We want this man to be given notice with the ROA pass. So it's gonna happen today. We're gonna hear Kuti Nasi. Then I'll come back here. I'll give you guys all the latest regarding to this, world story. And the next few days, as I said yesterday, that they're gonna be exciting because regarding to this whole issue. Yeah, Chief Justice Luke Malaba. And so, guys, this is our daily news on breaking news on Prince Mill Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel and follow us on all our social media platforms, Instagram and Facebook, Prince Mill Entertainment, and also our Facebook group, which is Prince Mill Entertainment TV. Thank you very much for listening and watching daily news on breaking news on Prince Mill Entertainment TV. Bless up.